Hey, what's up? My name's Alex, and I'm a Unity developer. But for the past 2 weeks, I've been learning Roblox development. Let's see how far I got. Welcome to my game, Alex's Backyard Farming Sim. But how did I make so much progress in so little time? How did I go from not knowing any Roblox development at all to all of this in just 2 weeks? When I first started Roblox development, I really had no idea where to look. So I did what I always do. I went on YouTube and started watching tutorials. And I also did something else. I went through and played a lot of different Roblox games. It was incredible to see how much effort and creativity was put into all of these different games. This step was all about trying to understand Roblox and its community. I soon came to realize that people play Roblox for all sorts of reasons. Some of the main ones are vibrant colors, engaging mechanics, excellent effects, and incredible themes. Also, during my research, I was tipped off to how powerful the plugins for Roblox Studio are, and I was amazed by how well everybody already understood client-server architecture. I soon realized that I was Grandpa. All these years I had been avoiding Roblox, thinking it was a baby game. It's an entire game engine. And as a Unity developer, I settled right in. First, I started with a picking up fruit mechanic to try to understand Lua. From there, I created a storage mechanic, meaning that you'd have to sell your fruit. So I made a fruit vendor. The storage was kind of small, so now you can use your gold from the fruit vendor at the storage upgrade. Now we were cooking. All this needed was some leaderboards. Pow! Actually, no. Pets! It's amazing what you can learn here on YouTube. And the best part was, anytime I wanted to change something up, a lot of the same logic I used in Unity applied here. It felt like I had started the race a mile ahead. And for some reason, Lua reminded me of a mashup of Python and Arduino code. I soon moved on to creating the second level. I wanted to make something vertical, so I thought a cliffside would be nice. I really got my use out of the Part to Terrain plugin here, and I love how everything came out. I was easily able to find a cool skybox in the toolbox and change the terrain colors to be more vibrant. I was also a little bored of just picking up fruit, so in addition to picking up coconuts, you can now shoot pineapple targets with a turret. While creating the turret, I used some stuff I learned about positioning the camera to help fix some of the issues that were happening. At this point, I had done a ton of work, and I wanted to start filling up my leaderboards. So I did something on Roblox called a sponsored experience ad, and for about $1, I was able to get 26 people to play my game. Hell yeah! I decided to run a few more ads on top of that. At this point, I was ready to start building the third level. I knew it was going to be a snow level, but I didn't really know what I wanted to build. So I went back and played some more Roblox games. And I found some games with awesome sword fighting mechanics. So that's what I was going to add. After testing out a few different solutions, I managed to settle on Raycast Hitbox version 4. Because honestly, it felt the best and was the least laggy solution. Also, those debug lines are pretty cool. And with all that done, I could finally move on to the most important part. Game passes! No, but in all seriousness, someone asked me to add one, so I figured why not? It would be good practice and I could probably learn something. Since then, I've added in a few more things, including a gold fusion, where you can fuse 3 normal pets into a gold version. And with that, I had done it. I had made a semi-polished game in just about 2 weeks using Roblox Studio. The power of this engine is intense and real, and I suggest any game developer to check it out. I'm curious, would you play the game I'm making, Kingdom Knights, if it was made in Roblox?